everyone, I'm Holly, and today I'm making a pumpkin soap. I think I'm going to call it Pickin' Pumpkins, and into this base I have a little darker cocoa butter, so it's a little darker than we're used to looking at. But the first thing I'm going to do is add in some pureed pumpkin. Now this is just some organic from a can from Thrive Market, and I think it's called Market, isn't it? Thrive? Anyway. I don't use a lot because I like to err on the side of caution, because I am adding milks to this as well. So we can add these purees and fun stuff to our soaps, but you know, with limits. So the sodium hydroxide, and that's the lye solution, it helps to preserve, you know, the milks and the purees, etc. It just creates an environment that all those, well, the germs and the bacteria, they don't really survive well in this environment at all. So we can add a little bit, I just don't like to overwhelm it. So I'm going to blend the pumpkin in. Now the pumpkin, even though it's orange, it's going to lend more of a yellow hue to the soap. So now I'm going to add in my milk mixture. This is goat milk and buttermilk. And I'm going to go ahead and get that blended in as well. Is looking really nice. You may see some little speckles, and that's just from the pumpkin. Now I have mixed up some micas. I have some copper mica and some orange mica, and that's going to help give this the color that we're looking for. Now the fragrance oil I'm using does discolor just a little bit, which is going to be perfect. Now in with the lye solution, and I do have a little bit of lye lint, but it's fresh, so in it goes. It just breaks up. All right, so now I'm just going to get this blended up nicely. So now I'm going to add in the fragrance oil, and I have a new fragrance oil that I'm using, and it smells like just fresh pumpkin and a little maple syrup and some nutmeg. It's so good. I was smelling the pumpkin with this fragrance oil on the side, and I was like, whoa, that smells like the most perfect fall treat. Okay, how fun is this? Doesn't it look amazing? I love using copper in my pumpkin soaps. Copper mica, that is, not real copper. It just always gives it kind of a little darker pumpkin color that I love. Let's stir this up. Little air bubbles got incorporated here, so it's kind of move those along, and see here, we're at a nice trace. It's getting thick, but since this is single color soap, this is in my farmhouse collection. I didn't even mention that yet. This is going to be for my farmhouse collection, so it's a goat milk and buttermilk soap. And this is my just absolutely favorite kind of pumpkin soap. It's just to have just a plain solid colored soap made with pumpkin. I love it. Alright, it's getting plenty thick, so I better get this poured in. Here we go. Yep, getting a little ploppy. That's fine because it's a single color. It works. And I find the thicker my soaps are, the less ash I get, even still, so it works. Get this all in, getting a little extra thick on me. I stick blended it plenty. But pumpkin fragrances do usually accelerate a little bit for me. I cannot wait to see how this looks once it discolors just a little bit. It's actually reminding me a little bit of buttered rum soap that I make. Color and a little bit of that just warm scent. Buttered rum will probably be around for Christmas, not the fall one. I kind of go back and forth, even though it's a, my picture is very Christmassy. Just trying to make sure this is fairly level. I'm going to smack it down some more. So I'm just going to kind of make a little bit of, some peaks and some drizzles, I guess. I usually keep my farmhouse soaps very simple. The farmhouse soaps, we do not bevel or plane. Just very rustic and homey and kind of old-fashioned like. I thought it would be fun to set up like a whole mood, like have some like some lights and just be have like, I don't know how I really thought I was gonna do it, but I was thinking some cozy like pumpkin soap making, but it's like 95 degrees here and it's hot upstairs and I'm like, cozy? I'm just not really feeling the cozy at the moment. I love cozy, but not when it's 95 degrees. It's like, give me a fan and a cold drink. But by the time you see this, it probably will be cozy season. All right, so here we have the new Pick and Pumpkin soap, and I'll see you back here for the cut. I'm back to cut this pumpkin soap, and it has discolored quite a bit. I think you can see that line around the edge, and so it's quite a bit darker on the top, and that's the color it's likely going to end up, or a little darker. It smells so good. It smells very warm and inviting. It's one of the better pumpkins that I've used. It was very strong on the maple out of bottle, and I made a candle. It's been a while ago now that I made the candle. Hold on. I haven't even trimmed its wick. It's probably been more than a month by now, 6 weeks, something like that. Anyway, it's very mapley, the fragrance actually in the candle. But it's quite delightful in this soap. So I notice I'm getting a little line, a little ridge. Some hesitation when I'm cutting. So, let me clean up this little piece of soap there. So here you can see this line is the discoloration. And what's happening here is just that it has not been exposed to the air because it's been recently cut. So this was an inside loaf. So we've got a line here, and we have a line here. So it will all end up being this darker kind of a orangey brown, orangey light brown. So it may go a little darker than the top, but this inside would have been just the perfect color. It reminds me a lot of a baked pumpkin dessert. I'm not just gonna say like a pumpkin pie, because I don't think we're there at the pumpkin pie stage, but because there's no real, you know, pie crust notes. There's some little speckles. I don't know if you can, let me try a different bar. It's really hard to see the speckles, but there are some speckles from the pumpkin. Here's one. We're gonna go right to this spot here and try to wait long enough to see if it'll focus. Anyway, the pumpkin does leave some fun speckles in the soap. And I don't know if you can see. Let me see. I'll take one of these bars I cut just a little while ago. So this loaf was closer to the edge. So we slice, we have the mold like so, okay? We cut the loaves this way, but we take a small strip off of each side and use those as samples. And so this bar was right up on that side that already started discoloring quite a bit. So it's worked its way in. Anyway, you can see that spot right there. That's sometimes how the fragrance oils just discolor. It can be a little spotty and you think, oh my goodness, what did I do wrong? But just give it time and it's gonna do its thing. That's why you'll find that a lot of us use like a color to kind of hide that modelly look as it's discoloring. I guess I took it away. You probably can't see that, but I took it away and then didn't put it back. So yeah, I think it's going to be okay, and I think it's going to be perfect for my farmhouse collection. I'm gonna clean off the wires here. Obviously, I'm not doing a very good job. It's so funny because I clean these wires just normally, and the pieces like shoot off the back of the table. I do have to vacuum quite a bit up here. Unfortunately, I do have some just like kind of industrial carpet up here. But someday we'll refinish the floors. If we're here that long, that is. I'd like to move on at some point before we do a whole lot to the place. Everybody knows my ultimate goal is to get back to Montana. Alright, so we have this last loaf here. I get 5 loaves out of this batch size. It's not my biggest mold. My biggest mold gets 6 loaves. I only made this a few days ago. It's pretty hard and it's just doing really well. We just sliced it an hour or so ago, so it's plenty hard for being, you know, a fresh big batch that's just been exposed to the air. Some people do think, comment from the videos that my soaps are soft because I can cut them at, you know, 1 to 2 weeks. Well, sometimes I do have to work at it a little bit. But I also don't use just an exaggerated amount of the hard oils that tend to be the over-cleansing ones, like coconut. And I do like palm, but if I use very much palm, and I don't have them in here, but when I use a soap that has a lot of palm in it, I'm not really a fan of that either. So my soaps just get a nice long cure, but they aren't super crazy wild hard at the very beginning. And I do love the lather that you get from, you know, the coconut and stuff, but sometimes it just strip your skin too much. So I just try to find a happy balance. So here we have this pumpkin batch, and it's looking pretty good. We're gonna discolor a little bit, obviously, but I'm going to put this on the curing rack where it's gonna hang out for over a month before we start pulling it off, and we'll get them boxed and ready for the next release. Well, there you go. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll talk to you later.